Warriors from the East. I can't hear you. Warriors from the East. Well, up in the East, the minister giving away 50% of his salary. Indeed, a remarkable servant leadership quality. And so, please help me make welcome from constituency number one, none other than the Honorable Hutchins Ian Liburd.
A very pleasant afternoon to you, my family. Family? I can't hear you. Family? I want to recognize all the distinguished persons in our presence. Of course, I must recognize our distinguished leader and Deputy Prime Minister, the Honorable Sean Kenneth Richards. Sometimes the protocol gets all mixed up, but I have to recognize the first Prime Minister, Sir Kennedy Simmons. And of course, my party and cabinet colleagues, the Honorable Eugene Hamilton. He was hot, eh? Give him a round of applause, man. Give him a round of applause. He was hot. Gene, you were hot today. The Honorable and former leader of our party, Lindsay Fitzpatrick Grant. Most people almost say Honorable Jonel Powell. Nothing wrong with that. You preach faith. You have to preach faith. And he's my fellow constituent, you know, so I can preach more faith than him. And of course, the man from Dong where? I almost said back of the land, boy. I almost said back of the land. The man from number 6, Pastor Connor. And all the former ministers of government, economist Hugh Heiliger, former Deputy Prime Minister, Mr. Powell. I almost said Tech McKee's minister. Richard Keyes. And of course, our first woman minister, Concy Mitchum. Our distinguished guest speaker is here with us. How can I forget my dear friend, an ambassador from Taiwan, Ambassador George Cho. Our governor's deputy and ambassador, I still call him Deputy Prime Minister, Sam Kondo. Yeah. And all the distinguished guests, and my warriors from the East. You know, I first want to thank Almighty God for blessing me with this opportunity to address this 51st party convention. I must also thank the people of East Basseterre for reposing their confidence in me. And I commit to you once again, I will never let you down. I made a commitment to give back half of my salary to my constituency. And I have done that. In the process, many of my fellow constituents have benefited from the Ian Patches Liburd Social Assistance and Youth Development Fund. Almost 1,000 hot lunches have been delivered. Medical and school supplies have been delivered throughout our entire constituency. For those constituents who are not aware, our constituency office is open daily, Monday to Friday, from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. And your humble servant is there from 10 until every Thursday and every Friday. You can get all the services at our constituency office. Your passport application forms, your land application forms, all the services are provided at our office there on Pond Road and Stainford Street. The job you gave me, my fellow constituents in East Bastille, I am taking it seriously. You know me, and I know you. I also want to thank the leadership and executive of the People's Action Movement for embracing me in this organization. And I commend the leader and Deputy Prime Minister, the Honorable Sean Kenneth Richards, who has brought this great party back from the political doldrums. And just like Sir Kennedy, former leader, brought the party out of the political doldrums, Sean has won 4 seats, as you've heard, under his leadership. And in so doing, PAM is back in the government. So I know we understand the significance of 4. Dr. Simmons, 4. Sean, 4. And I know about 4. You? But many years ago, a budding politician said to me that Kitchens have a 3-day syndrome. And when I asked him what he meant, he said to me, after 3 days, we forget everything. True? But my family, when I reflect today on what that budding politician said to me about our 3-day syndrome 15 years ago, and when I listen to some of our people, even our supporters, mumbling and grumbling, I am tempted to say respectfully, like the budding politician, some of us do have a 3-day syndrome. So I have come today to ask you and the entire federation 2 very simple questions. 1, have you stopped in the last 30 months to think about the reasons why we needed to change the Douglas Labour NRP government on the 16th of February 2015? Have you stopped to think? That's the first question. The second question I want to ask you, what would St. Kitts Nevis be like today if there was a change in government? What would St. Kitts be like today? That's the second question I want to ask today. Because you see, when we reflect on the last 30 months of Team Unity, I believe it is important, it is also imperative that we examine what I call our inheritance as a new administration. We have to recall, and Jonel helped us somewhat, some way. But lest we forget that we inherited a country which was labeled the murder capital of the world. We forget that? That is the country that Denzel Douglas and his Labour NRP Party administration willed to us as a Team Unity. And I get no comfort in saying this, but under the Douglas Labour NRP, We had over 200 murders. Look at the state of affairs today. The police and the team unity have introduced a 6-point plan. They have introduced their presence. When we make a comparative analysis to the years gone by, we've had too many murders this year. I think they're just about 6. Look back, they would have been 16. Aren't you feeling safer on the team unity? Aren't you? Lest we forget, my family, we inherited a country with a crumbling public infrastructure. Public buildings in a state of disrepair, in a state of dilapidation. Instead of repairing the buildings, he rent buildings for most of his friends. The total expenditure on rental of office space for government is in excess of 17,319,776 dollars over the past 18 years in this country. How many buildings we could have constructed? How many buildings we could have repaired? What happened to the Barsi High School? I'm sure Tom will talk about that. Look at our sporting facilities. Look at our roads in disrepair. And we in the Ministry of Public Infrastructure will not leave roads to political expediency. As you see, we are repairing our roads day to day as we go along. Lest we forget, we inherited a country with a constitution that was perpetually flouted by this 10-man-in-1 called Douglas. Our parliament had become a useless instrument, as described by a former Chief Justice in the OACS. You forget what Douglas did in Parliament with the new boundaries? And we have a right to say, God bless the Privy Council. Yes. So when the debate comes about the CCJ, people must understand that a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush. And I know that I will be misunderstood and misquoted. But I can deal with that. But we cannot forget what the Privy Council did for us. Lest we forget, we inherited a country with an agricultural sector that was not important to the last administration. The man closed the sugar industry in 2005 over his dead body. And when you look around, you think we're seeing cane? We see wild bush forests all around the country. And now we're trying to blame the monkey population and we can't get agriculture going. The man closed the sugar industry over his dead body. Lest we forget, we inherited a citizenship by investment program under threat by the United States of America. Because of the illicit actors that Douglas brought. Yes, we welcome the Honorable Prime Minister, Timothy Harris. Dr. the Honorable Timothy Harris. That's what unity is all about. But lest we forget, my family, we inherited a country with our CBI program under threat. The United States of America chastised the 10-man-in-1 about the illicit actors. The Canadian government lifted off visa-free waiver. What are we thinking about when we're mumbling and we're grumbling? Lest we forget, we inherited a country where people could not pay their electricity bills. And what did the man do? No solution, he said, he wanted to cry. situation in our country. I hear the Calypsonian who can't finish his song. Blame me for the drought. Imagine, he say blame patches for the drought. Why you don't go finish this song? Eh? Why don't he blame your father, Congress? Congress, blame your father for speed tech and $6 million and leave me alone. But this water situation, my family, could have been avoided if we did not have an incompetent minister like Asim or Walters Martin. He did not take heed to the warning given by Ocean Earth Technologies in 2009 about the trend of declining static water levels observed in the Bastia well field. OET warned, and I quote from the report, "This decline is observed to range from 1.5 to 2 feet according to available data extending back into the 1970s. The decline in water levels appears to have accelerated from 1999 to 2009 with an increase in groundwater withdrawals. Continued dewatering of the aquifer will lead to increased areas of salt water intrusion and declining potable water quality within the well field. Three zones of salt water intrusion have already been identified in the well field area by MER mapping." That's from 2009, 7 years ago. The man was warned, the government was warned, they did absolutely nothing. Nothing. Well, what action we have taken with the water? And the Prime Minister has just stepped in and give him some kudos because he just released some money to the ministry. $600,000 upon the millions already given to the water department. And we just commissioned works in mansions where we're taking some 160,000 gallons of water that's in a 200,000 gallon well and piping it up to Phillips and Molyneux and Borio. So the people won't have no issues with water in that area in the next couple of months. For the people in East Basseterre, we have gotten release for $300,000 to start a well drilling project, north of the RLB International Airport that will hopefully bring us on stream an additional 900,000 gallons of water to augment the aquifer source over there in East Basseterre. So we are taking action. In terms of the electricity, we have introduced a new energy policy. Just last week or week before, we commissioned a solar energy plant. I must thank the government of the people of the Republic of China on Taiwan on behalf of our government. And our ambassador is here, Ambassador Sanatego Bao, please. Through the government of the Republic of the People of China and Taiwan, beg your pardon, we are now generating some 1.2 megawatts of solar power in St. Kitts. Wind energy, we are also looking at that. And we have received a power purchase agreement from North Star. Remember during our campaign, I said for 7 years, they told us about wind energy in Borio, right? Bellevue. I always mix it up. The money was there. Somebody said that Douglas said the wind was blowing down there. Remember I tell you so? I tell you, no wind was blowing to blow the money under somebody's desk. But we have reached the stage. We are now looking at the power purchase agreement. And AG, it's with your office. Give us a legal opinion soon. Geothermal, my family, we are blessed with two volcanoes. And as part of our policy, we have decided and we have agreed that it must be irresponsible of us as a government if we did not establish whether there is a geothermal resource on St. Kitts, and if so, develop that resource without retarding the progress on Nevis. And I can report that preliminary findings look positive. That's what I'll say at this time. But in conclusion, my family, the thrust of my message to you today is to help us to remember where we came from and where we are right now. And I want to say to you, in closing, do not be fooled by some of those who you hear on the talk shows. Even some of those who host their own talk shows. Not you, Richard, not you. Some of them, they come across like they're holier than thou. I know one who believes he's the expert on the economy, on social issues, an expert in law and government. No, let me correct that, because he's a lawyer, he was in government. But when you hear him talking, you ask yourself if he got a three-day syndrome. Truly. Because he was in government. Who he be? He gets a big lump sum gratuity. He secure a contract for hundreds of thousands of dollars from Douglas. And he still getting a fat pension. You work out who he be. The point I'm making, my family, do not be fooled by some of them who all of a sudden they ain't got what they want, so they're criticizing Team Unity. That they claim to support. They're criticizing Team Unity because they get what they want. And they still say they support Team Unity. They want to change the government. They want to change the prime minister. But they still support Team Unity. But Team Unity is strong. Team Unity is strong because of PAM. Team Unity is strong because of CCM and PLP. And as I look into the audience, I see Sam Kondo and his wife, Jean Kondo, Ambassador Sam and Jean. Who would have ever believed that Sam Kondo and Jean would be hubby and Pam? That's unity. Who would have believed that Tim Harris would be getting this role wrapped with applause in Pam? That's unity. That's what unity about. And when some people talking about they get rid of Simmons and they get rid of Douglas and they could get rid of Tim, what nonsense they're talking. Huh? One man get rid of Douglas, you know. Not me. May I take it that prayer? Not me. Because when Tim Harris, excuse me, I'm going to say Tim for now, Prime Minister, when the Honorable Prime Minister got up in Parliament with his famous speech, "If I perish, I perish." What happened to him? Douglas fired him. But Sam could have stayed with Douglas. Sam could have stayed with Douglas. Get a nice cushy gratuity like the other one. Get a nice pension. Sam and I talk. But think Sam stayed with Douglas? No. Sam fired his resignation. For 2 days, he had accepted his resignation, calling Sam. And I was there when he called Sam. I can tell you what Sam said, because I may think Sam is a liar. But let me finish here. I want to finish here, because I want to Lord Sam and Tim and ask them to stand in Pam and get a wonderful round of applause. Please Sam, please Jean. So all I want to say finally, we don't need no operation to rescue us. The people of St. Kitts and Nevis did just that on the 16th February 2015. And save us from tyranny and dictatorship under Douglas. The people saved us after 20 years of disarray in this country. Then how on earth can we turn around in 30 months? We can't turn around in 30 months. No. There can never be a quick fix to the problems we inherited in my family. So we don't want no operation to rescue us. The operation was done on the February 15th last year. 16th. You're sharp. So I want to say, like Gene Hamilton and like Reverend Jesse Jackson, let us keep hope alive. Love your party, Pam. Love CCM. Love PLP. And love your country. God bless you, my family. I love you.
Members and friends of the People's Action Movement, PAM, moving forward, creating opportunities for all. At this